A man with a criminal history will soon face charges for a crime spree that started in Foley and lasted days before his arrest in St. Paul. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Kate Renner is live in Minneapolis and joins us now with the latest on a pretty bizarre story, Kate.
Yeah, just 39-year-old Brandon Stark went on a crime spree that lasted 48 hours, and it spanned three different counties. Now, it all started early Wednesday morning in Foley, Minnesota, when Stark is accused of kidnapping a Coburn grocery store employee and then forcing that employee to drive him to Northeast Minneapolis. Now, as I said, Stark has an extensive criminal record. He just got out of prison on May 6th for aggravated robbery, aggravated assault, and criminal sexual conduct. He's supposed to be on supervised release. Now, Wednesday, after the alleged kidnapping, the Department of Corrections put out a warrant for his arrest. Fast forward now to Thursday night, just before 9 o'clock, Stark pops up again in Northeast Minneapolis. This time, he forces a woman to walk him to her car at knife point. The woman threw her keys at him and ran into the Anchor Fish and Chips restaurant at 3rd Street and 13th Avenue. Stark then allegedly kidnapped another woman and had her drive him to South Minneapolis. But at the Holiday gas station on 46th and Hiawatha, that woman ran into the gas station. Police say Stark then carjacked a man at those gas pumps and took his Mitsubishi Galant on a joyride over the Ford Bridge into St. Paul. Minneapolis police chased him along the parkway. Exactly 32 minutes after that first attempted kidnapping, the suspect hit four parked cars along the parkway. He was taken into custody. Here you can see video of that pileup. Highland Park neighbors say it was quite a sight to see.
Came up to actually take pictures and see all of it. It's pretty amazing. It looks like that car drove into that one. You can see an empty space there and rubble where another car was, and even that Toyota up there got damaged.
Now, Stark is currently in custody with the Department of Corrections. Today, he will be interviewed by Minneapolis police. According to Minneapolis police, he will likely face charges of kidnapping, attempted kidnapping, and auto theft, in addition to whatever the Department of Corrections charges him with. Reporting live in Minneapolis, Kate Renner, 5 Eyewitness News.